Hi everyone, this is Linda with a new video and my best tips for hybrid piecing patchwork of the crosses, sewing some seams by hand and some seams by machine. My mission is to make quilting more accessible, less expensive, faster, easier, and more accurate, whether you use Inklingo or not. I'm giving my best tips for chain piecing from crosshair to crosshair by machine and for continuous stitching by hand. These are two methods I love using and enjoy teaching. I'll show you how I choose which seams to sew by machine and which seams to sew by hand. This is good info for any quilter, especially if you want to be happy with the results and finish what you start. Hybrid piecing can make any design easier, faster, and more accurate, and Patchwork of the Crosses is a perfect example. I think you'll find it interesting even if you've started with English paper piecing. Hexagons always have inset seams like this. Hand piecers love them and machine piecers avoid them. Inset seams help me decide which seams to sew by hand and which seams to sew by machine. I know that I can get the most benefit and enjoyment from hand piecing when I stitch continuously, turning a corner at the end of every seam and carrying on without breaking the thread. And inset seams are perfect for that. For chain piecing by machine, I want it to be easy to stay organized so I can feed the shapes under the needle one after another without mistakes and ripping. The idea is to get a fast start by sewing pairs, triples, and rows by machine and then sewing the rest by hand, sewing anywhere, anytime. I'm using the original 1-inch size hexagon, sometimes called a honeycomb. When I use the smaller 1/2 inch and 3/4 inch sizes, I hand piece everything and plan for as much continuous stitching as possible. The hybrid technique I'm demonstrating is also great for the 1.5 inch 90 degree hexagon and many other designs. I'm demonstrating the hybrid sewing sequence illustrated on page 23 of the book. It is just one possible approach. There are other ways to organize the shapes for hybrid piecing. You can choose a different sequence. When we hand piece, we always stitch from crosshair to crosshair, not edge to edge. That is different from chain piecing by machine, where we usually sew from edge to edge. For a hybrid, I want to sew from crosshair to crosshair on all the seams, including the machine piece ones, because it gives me the best sewing and pressing options. You might be surprised how easy it is to sew from crosshair to crosshair by machine when all of the seams are exactly the same length and you have a line to follow. If you take a minute to sew with different stitch lengths, you will find the right one so that if you start at one crosshair, you will always end easily at the other. I'm using the setting for 2.5 on my machine for the 1-inch hexagons. Another factor that makes it easy to sew from crosshair to crosshair is that as long as you don't stitch beyond the crosshair into the seam allowance, close is good enough. In other words, it's okay to end a little bit short. You decide whether or not to backstitch at the beginning and end of every seam. I find it easy on my machine because I have a walking foot and automatic needle down, and the reverse button is located conveniently. You may decide not to backstitch, knowing that every seam will be attached to a crossing seam. If you're using Inklingo, you might want to print a page of hexagons on scrap fabric and practice sewing from crosshair to crosshair first. Like anything, you might have to rip a few until you're comfortable with a new technique. Sewing from crosshair to crosshair means I really do need the lines. For hybrid piecing, I want the sewing lines and crosshairs marking the seam endings on every hexagon. Of course, I almost always print the shapes with Inklingo, but you can use freezer paper templates and mark the sewing lines with a mechanical pencil, the way we do for quilted diamonds, if you prefer. Part 1 of this video series explains using freezer paper templates for Patchwork of the Crosses, and it is the technique taught in my Quilted Diamonds books. Printing is faster than drawing the sewing lines with a pencil, but drawing the lines is faster than any method of basting for English paper piecing. Monkey says, try it, you'll like it. Just about everything else is the same as normal machine piecing and hand piecing with Inklingo. For example, if you use an open toe or zipper foot, you have a good view of the lovely lines. As usual, I use a stiletto to feed the shapes to avoid trailing off like this. To make a toothpick stiletto, use a button and a glue gun. The button will keep your stiletto from rolling away. You can make a stiletto to match every mood. These are 2.5-inch toothpicks, but you could use an orange stick or a cocktail fork if you like something a bit longer. I have a cute one from a friend in Holland. I feel comfortable using wood, and I can replace the toothpicks if a point gets too dull to grip. You might prefer something big and chunky, or something as slim as a hat pin. I always wear a finger pincushion, whether I'm sewing by hand or by machine. I used to make them with elastic and a button, and I made a little video showing that years ago. I'll put a link to that below the video screen. When I discovered ring blanks at a beading store, I was thrilled. It may not seem like a big deal, but I think once you've tried it once, you'll feel naked when you don't have one on your finger. As usual, when we machine piece with Inklingo, we try to sew beside the sewing line, not on it, to get a scant 1/4-inch seam allowance. Everything else is the same, a fresh needle, and remove the pins as you go if you're pinning, and always leave something under the needle, either a scrap of fabric or another pair of hexagons. If you've been following me for the last 20 years or so, you know that if I plan to hand piece the whole block, I would have the shapes laid out on my sewing surface to look like the block, usually wrong side up. In this case, I laid them out right side up because I want you to see the pretty fussy cutting. There is info for fussy cutting in part 2 of this video series, and like this video, the info is valuable whether you use Inklingo or not. I'd like to share a few other suggestions for hybrid piecing your Patchwork of the Crosses to create conditions that make it more likely that you will finish your quilt. First, I recommend adding the plain hexagons when you are sewing the block, so you don't leave all the boring bits to the end. If you add the ring when you sew each block, you just need to add the squares when you assemble the quilt top. That is straightforward, relaxing, continuous stitching, and especially effortless when you print the shapes with Inklingo. Secondly, instead of laying the block out to look like the block, I want to arrange the hexagons in sets that will be easy to machine piece, so I can get a fast start with some chain piecing. You don't have to break the block down the way I did, as long as you have the shapes laid out in order beside the sewing machine, so you can sew the correct sides together. Thirdly, at the end of each machine piecing session, take 30 seconds to lay out the next shapes ready to sew. So even if you only have a few minutes to sew next time, you can sit down and accomplish something. In each case, I'm machine piecing triples, but notice the difference. Different sides are sewn together. Once I have assembled these sets, I will finish by hand and leave all the pressing to the end. There are four sets of three hexagons in the first ring around the four patch. I chain piece from crosshair to crosshair. Then I lay the shapes out again and sew the four seams to finish the ring. The first ring of sets of three hexagons is simple to sew together because the sides are obvious. But joining the larger ring together is a bit trickier. I have tried sewing the entire ring of 24 plain hexagons before I start adding them to the block, and I always seem to make a mistake and have to rip. For me, it is better to add the sets of three hexagons to the block by hand, one set at a time. It gives me the continuous stitching I crave without ripping. Now I'm all set up for continuous stitching by hand. I am not covering all the details of hand piecing in this short video. I cover needles, thread, threading the needle, knots, pinning, and all the rest in several other places, including in the Patchwork of the Crosses book. The most complete directions are in my Quilted Diamonds books and demonstrated in the 2-hour DVD lesson that is included with Quilted Diamonds 2. For hand piecing, we only ever sew through two layers of fabric. So at the end of the seam, I pass the needle through the crossing seam allowances in the crosshair when necessary. Sometimes I just need to turn the corner. As usual, I backstitch on each side at the beginning and end of every seam. Now we have all the benefits of hand piecing: precision, portability, and the very best pressing options. I hope this brief video helps you understand why my first choice for Patchwork of the Crosses is hybrid piecing. It gives me the best of both worlds. Fern in Singapore used hybrid piecing in this fabulous example of Patchwork of the Crosses. It was exhibited in Houston and was a sensation in the Tokyo Quilt Show in 2015. A combination of hand and machine piecing might be the right choice for you too. I also hope you can see why a design like Patchwork of the Crosses does not have to be a lifetime project. Choosing the fabric and fussy cutting will probably take more time than actually sewing the quilt together. From the front, I don't think anyone can tell which seams are sewn by hand and which seams are sewn by machine. You'd have to look at the back, and doesn't the back look nice? Here's a tip. If you press the center of each block the same way, in this case clockwise around the intersection, everything will work out perfectly when you join the blocks together to assemble the quilt top. I'm working on a Patchwork of the Crosses pressing video for part 4 of this series, so I hope you'll come back. By the way, everything I've said about hybrid piecing applies to the designs in Wileen Hammerstein's Millefiori Quilts books, Quilted Diamonds, Pieced Hexagons, and many, many others. English paper piecing, hand piecing with a running stitch, machine piecing, and hybrid piecing are all described and illustrated in my Lucy Boston Patchwork of the Crosses book. With or without Inklingo, my mission is to make quilting more accessible so more people can enjoy being creative with fabric and love the results. Hybrid piecing is part of the mix. I always want to know what you have to say about my videos. Please check the links below and leave a comment. It also helps me if you click to like the video. Thank you for watching.